cares for over 200 children. 10 houses are situated round the pleasant green, each one being divided to accommodate 2 families. In addition, there are hostels for apprentices. The branch has its own bakery, the baker is an old boy of the home, and more than 150 loaves are baked here each day. The baker makes plenty of cakes as well. Care is either the food here is attractive as well as nourishing. Kitchen gardens provide most of the vegetables that are required, and the head gardener is also a qualified teacher of gardening. Helping in the orchard is a popular task. Enough apples are grown here in a good season to meet needs throughout the winter. The home has its own dental surgery. It is fully equipped, and a dentist pays a visit once a week to give any treatment that may be needed. The Harpenden branch has its own sick bay with a qualified nurse in charge. There are several small wards and an isolation wing. The children have their own beautiful chapel in the grounds where services are held on Sundays. After school, there is plenty of opportunity for fun and games. When you are very young, you are very adaptable. Already, Sally and Christopher are enjoying themselves, although it is only a few days since they arrived. Of course, they have moments when they think of the past, and they ask sometimes when their mother is coming to see them. But already, they are settling down with their newfound friends. What we have seen happening in Harpenden is happening also in the many other branches of the National Children's Home in Britain, such as at Bramhope, near Leeds, Painswick, in Gloucestershire, Nottingham, Frodsham in Cheshire, Newcastle, Rother Glen, the new branch near Glasgow, Alverstoke in Hampshire, and many others too numerous to mention. 27 general branches, 7 special branches, 4 approved schools, and 2 staff training colleges. How did this great work begin? In the year 1869,